Well, hello and welcome back to Unit 5 of this European SchoolNet Academy games-based learning course. And of course, Module 5 is all about designing games. Now, this is a little unit on some advanced games design tools. We've already looked at some simple games design tools, we've had a bit of an introduction, and we've looked at some game design tools that could be used for certainly younger children, but always for the young at heart. What we're going to have a little look at in this module here are some tools that are perhaps a little bit more advanced, so perhaps the young people need to maybe be a little bit more older. First one we're going to have a quick look at is something which is called RPG Game Maker. If you're familiar with software for the Nintendo DS, then even though this is a PC-based game, the actual types of game that you're able to produce with RPG Game Maker look like the types of game that you'd normally play on the Nintendo DS. They're map-based, which means that you explore different aspects of the game, and the most importantly, they're incredibly narrative-driven. You can develop your own stories, you can develop your own fight scenes, you can develop your own different pathways, so depending on which direction you want to take the game in and the choices that the game player makes will depend on the actual outcome of the game. Now we're going to have a look at something called the UDK, the Unreal Development Kit. Now, even though you might not have heard of the Unreal Development Kit before, you've probably heard of some of the games that's been used to create. All the Batman games, for example, or Infinity Blade, are used and created using the UDK. What people don't realise about the UDK, though, is that it's actually a free game engine which can be used by schools. It's got a licensing agreement with it, so you can use the kit for free. However, if you go on to sell your game, then you need to pay quite a bit of royalties back to the UDK team. But what this means for us in schools is that actually we can use industry standard games design software for free in our schools. And that's a pretty empowering thing, and something which UDK, I know, are very, very keen to support. Now, the thing about UDK is it's a step up from any other game engines that we've looked at already. And as a result of that, it's also pretty complicated to use. Although there's lots and lots of really, really good tutorials that are available that you could either work through with your students or they could indeed work through by themselves. You've only got to look at some of the features of what can be created in UDK to realise that it's a pretty amazing piece of software. Just look how beautiful this screenshot looks here because of the adjusted lighting. Again, just like good game engines, it's also got a really advanced physics engine. As you would expect, the physics engine for the UDK contains quite a lot of quite complex mathematics. It's not just physics and what the game can do, it's also around different effects that can happen as well in the game, depending on which way your character is looking, or indeed depending on what time of day it is within the game as well. As well as effects and as well as the physics engine, you can also carry out a number of visual scriptings to ensure that certain things happen when you want them to happen because of a delay. And in this example here, this is looking at the visual scripting for a sandstorm which is going to happen during the game. Again, visual scripting tools can be used to introduce older children into what's actually required when we talk about gameplay, and also to introduce an element of storytelling. The other nice thing about the UDK is, similar to Project Spark and Kodu, we've also got a way that we can introduce different levels. This ensures that the game remains progressive, but also, of course, you can get different students to work on a different level of a game. So that, again, we can introduce that element of collaboration. So, that was a couple of quite advanced games designed units that you could actually use with your children in your classroom. Again, the Royal Society of Edinburgh has produced two other things which you might find of interest. Although they're not specifically related to games design, again, they've got games design which permeates through them. One is called I Love My Smartphone, which encourages young people to develop smartphone apps. And the other one is a unit on information and web databases. Remember, there are very, very sophisticated databases behind all games design units. So there we go. We've reached the end of Module 5, and I hope you've enjoyed it.